the governor launched the first ever support price-based procurement system for apples in the state of Jammu and Kashmir. This is a unique scheme. As you are aware, that the state produces around 20-22 lakh metric tons of apple. Nearly 75% of the production of the entire country. We have taken note of the various concerns raised by apple farmers regarding rates being offered to them, particularly of C-grade variety, as well as issues of transportation. And the proposed support price-based procurement scheme addresses all these concerns. Apples of all varieties will be procured. Rates have been fixed so as to incentivize people to sell at good prices. But of course, there is no compulsion to anybody to sell. This is purely a support mechanism. There are four collection centers or mandis which have been initially nominated: Parimpura, Shupian, Sopor, Botingu, enabling procurement literally at the doorstep of the farmer. No farmer will now have to make any distress sale, particularly of C-grade apple. In fact, our estimate is that sale of C-grade apple alone through this scheme could end up benefiting the farmers by almost 800 crore rupees. Payment times have been fixed through direct benefit transfer scheme and within 3 working days. Transportation is also the responsibility of the procurer, so there are no issues for the farmer as far as transportation is concerned. The divisional commissioner and his team of deputy commissioners are constantly monitoring the process. We estimate that nearly 50% of farmers in the Kashmir Valley are apple growers, say around 7 lakhs. This scheme will directly or indirectly touch more than 3 million farmers. This is just one of the many initiatives which are in the pipeline to provide welfare and assistance. The government has identified 85 schemes of different kinds, cutting across departments and ministries, which are individual beneficiary oriented. These schemes include scholarships, pensions, housing for rural and urban poor, etc. These schemes have been identified and departments have been mandated to ensure 100% coverage of all eligible beneficiaries in Jammu, Kashmir and Ladakh. This means that without any constraint of traditional budgetary allocations, which is prevalent in the rest of the country, here in Jammu, Kashmir and Ladakh, 100%, which means all eligible beneficiaries will be covered, assisted under these identified schemes. On the law and order front, as you are aware, restrictions have been lifted from nearly all areas. Insofar as Kashmir Valley is concerned, landlines are fully functional. Considerable mobiles are functional in Kupwara and Handwara. Traffic on the road has increased manifold. The situation has remained peaceful by and large. Since August 5, we have had a total of 187 law and order incidents. 165 of them have been in Srinagar district alone. We have had an increase till August 16th, but after August 16th, there has been a consistent decline. And I think, as you would have seen from the removal of restrictions and the increased traffic on the road, things are fast getting to normal. Provocations have not stopped us from opening 96 exchanges in the state. They have not stopped us from making landlines functional in the state. They have not stopped us from removing all restrictions to free movement. They will not stop us from taking all other actions, but we will do it at an appropriate time.
So what keeps
us? Okay,
Mr. Kansal, can I?
Can I?
Kansal, I have a question.
I think I'm taking more questions.
It's about the young generation.
At least for landlines, services like fire services, like police, at least that can be done.
Mr. Kansal.
Azan, somebody.
Mr. Kansal, this side, in front of you.
Mr. Kansal,
who have adopted, will they be affected?
No. You see, I think what you're trying to ask is, the attempt is not to disrupt any existing systems. The attempt is not to disrupt any existing systems, whether they be trade systems, whether they be logistic systems, whether they be any other systems. The attempt is to support farmers in order to ensure that nobody is forced to make a distress sale. If they want to go with an existing system, if they have a pre-existing arrangement, good luck. They are welcome to do it. But if they want to come and sell it at a price which is obviously much higher than the price that they would have sold at a distress, they are also welcome. Preventive detention is something which is a decision taken by the law enforcing authority with due application of mind and after taking into account all the prevailing circumstances. I don't think it is something which is to be made light of. And by the way, preventive detention for maintenance of law and order very much exists in the statute book. So if anybody has been taken in preventive custody, it is after due application of mind by the local authorities and very much under the ambit of the law.
B.Ed. or D.Ed. এর জন্য বিশ্বস্ত প্রতিষ্ঠান ইদান টিচার্স ট্রেনিং কলেজ. বিশদ জানতে যোগাযোগ করুন এই নম্বরে. কংক্রিটের এই জঙ্গলে ফিরে আসুক সবুজ ঝড়, বন্ধ করে প্লাস্টিক, পরিবেশ হোক পরিষ্কার. গুটখা বা সিগারেট নিষিদ্ধ, মারণ সেন্সেশন, রূপশ্রীতেও পাশে আছে আসানসোল মিউনিসিপ্যাল কর্পোরেশন. Please don't forget to subscribe our channel and also click the bell icon to get the latest updates.